So to outline this further, we're about to go deep into the science of fasting. And I want you to understand this. I've mentioned this before. It gets a little bit tricky here. So we're going to talk about two things. We're going to talk about autophagy. Autophagy. Okay, some people say autophagy, whatever you want to do, right? But it's called autophagy. And autophagy can be thought of as cell death. Autophagy through metabolism of the cells. And then there's something called apoptosis. Now, apoptosis is actual programmed cell death. The body seeks out malfunctioning cells and targets them and eliminates them, which is fantastic, and I'll explain why, right? So I want you to remember something. I need to write this for you. I'm running out of room, guys. So autophagy, apoptosis, you got that. So I want to explain to you that every single tissue in the human body, your nail, your eyelid, your skin, your heart, your bones, all of your tissues are made up of cells. We've gone over this before, right? So you have amino acids combine to create proteins. So you got all these little amino acids, right? Amino acids create proteins. Proteins create cells. Cells create tissue. You, okay? So amino acids make up proteins. Proteins make up cells. Cells make up tissues. What does this mean? This means that all tissues in the human body are proteins, right? Of course, it has to be. All tissues are proteins. So I want to explain this to you. Autophagy metabolizes old proteins, thus destroying them. And that is a fantastic thing. When the body is fasting and looking for energy, it preferentially chooses to break down proteins that are old, that you no longer need, or that are malfunctioning, such in apoptosis, right? So I want to explain this to you with the gas tank, right? So let's say we have the gas tank, okay? So we have fat here, let's say, I'll do it like this so I can show you. Fat, we have sugar, right? So now we've already burned through the sugar, okay? We burned through the sugar, so we're dealing with fat. Your body has essential fatty acids, right? It has an essential body fat. There's body fat you don't want to get lower than, or you're going to start to have health problems too. So what happens is you'll store enough essential body fat to survive. So let's call this essential body fat down here. And that means that right around here is you're going to get autophagy and apoptosis, right? So the body's going to start searching for alternative fuel sources. It doesn't want to burn all of your fat, because without fat, you die. So it will start targeting other things to burn for energy, namely proteins that it can break apart into amino acids, and it can burn them. It can burn protein as glucose. This is also gluconeogenesis, right? So it metabolizes its own cells. Now, this is why with obese individuals, when they're fasting, let's put obese, they're going to be burning 90% of total calories from fat. Why? There's no polite way to say this. They have thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands of calories worth of stored body fat in the form of triglycerides, right? This is why in lean individuals, those of you out there that don't need to lose weight, if we talk about lean individuals, even in a full fast, they're only going to burn about 78% of total calories from fat, because they simply don't have enough, right? So autophagy and apoptosis actually starts faster for lean people with less hours of fasting, which is the main reason why I do fasting, and I'll get into that too. So the reason why I outline this idea of autophagy and apoptosis right now is because I want to explain to you the issue that everybody asked me about with weight loss. Now, a lot of you dealt with it before you got to me. There's not much I can do for you after the fact, but that is the topic of excess skin, okay? So when people lose weight, they have this severe problem with excess skin. They need a tummy tuck. They need surgery. They need all these things, right? So the issue with excess skin is once it's already there, it's a little bit trickier to deal with. So when people lose fat via fasting, they never need surgery. They never need surgery. They never need tummy tucks. They never need anything, because the body handles it itself through autophagy and apoptosis. Let me explain. All of your tissues are made up of protein. Your skin is literally nothing but protein. All the cells of your skin, it's collagen protein, in fact, right? Collagen is the most abundant protein source in the entire body. That's why I put it in my Perfect Paleo powder. So your skin is protein. So if you allow autophagy to happen, when the body's searching for a fuel source and it's gotten down to the point where it doesn't have any more body fat to give up, it just goes, oh, look at these old proteins over here. Our body's shrinking. We don't need all that excess protein, and it starts breaking down that protein, right? And all of a sudden, the excess tissue problem takes care of itself. The body literally metabolizes all the excess skin. It's fantastic. It's absolutely incredible if you think about it. And this is also why lean muscle tissue is maintained while fasting, because the body is going to search for old proteins, unused proteins, to break them down before it breaks down something like its own muscle tissue. Why would it do that? I don't need this excess skin. It's not serving a purpose. Let me burn that up and metabolize that before I start accessing my own lean muscle tissue. This is why these people actually gain muscle tissue, because they lost more body fat, right? So constantly eating the lean chicken and brown rice completely throws this off. It just screws up everything physiologically, screws up your hormones. You never get autophagy, you never get apoptosis, doesn't happen. So this is an example of autophagy helping with physique goals. So this autophagy thing is also where the longevity health benefits come from. So if I am a lean person, I don't have much body fat to lose, right? So I want the benefits of autophagy and apoptosis. What are the benefits of autophagy and apoptosis? Well, it's the fact that these proteins that are laying around that you don't need, that are muddying up the waters. Have you ever heard the term precancerous cells? Doctors always love to tell you that all human beings have precancerous cells. These are cells with growth abnormalities, or these are cells that are malfunctioning, the cellular signal is disrupted, they are old proteins, these are cells you don't need, these precancerous or malfunctioning cells. You want to get rid of those. The only time you can flush those out, like a Zamboni, flush out all the bad junk, is when you are fasting. Right? So this is why people like me, especially in like cancer is one big one, Alzheimer's, it's also proven that old ass proteins gummy up the brain. They cause all these problems in the brain. So some of the symptoms of Alzheimer's are due directly in part to these old proteins. So you can eliminate those proteins before you ever have problems in old age. This is the longevity benefits of autophagy and apoptosis. This is why it is one of the single most effective tools for disease prevention ever. Okay? One of the most successful tools for disease prevention ever in lean people and obese people. Okay? So the apoptosis is the programmed cell death where it literally goes, oh, that cell is going to kill us, and it attacks it and gets rid of it, right? But the body can't do these things because it's so busy doing what? Digesting all the time. Constantly digesting, 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 digesting. All your blood flow, all this stuff is going to digestion because you're eating every 2 to 3 hours. You never give it a chance to do these things, right? It's crazy. So apoptosis and autophagy is so powerful that some people, I'm not saying me, okay? Some people believe that if you did a 7-day water fast once or maybe twice a year, that the rest of the time you could eat whatever you want and never get cancer. Literally, never get cancer. Pretty crazy. Now, I don't fall into that camp. I understand it, but your odds are even higher if you do a few extended fasts a year and you eat according to the Clovis protocol the rest of the time. Your odds then go through the roof, right? Why? Why eat crappy just because you can? It just doesn't make any sense. Why risk that? You know, so I always recommend a Clovis-approved diet. And I personally, this is the apoptosis and autophagy is what I personally use fasting for. I'll tell you the exact type of fasting that I use here in a minute.